what the heck is your deal?
I bet you're all wondering why I gathered all of you here today. You all have one thing in common. You losers, you all failed my English course. As a result, you will all be tributes in the 50th annual English Games.
What? This is not fair!
Oh, yes.
Whoever is the last one standing in the arena will receive a passing grade in my courses. May the odds be never in your favor.
Welcome to the 50th annual English Games. I'm Dan Smith.
I'm A.A. Rambalakay.
And today do we have a show for you. Five fabulous contestants have met together, all failed their English courses, to duke it out for a passing grade.
Yeah, that's right, Dan. With these five contestants, they all failed English in one specific way. Let's see, throughout the English Games, if their trait evolves.
I completely agree, A.A. Ron. It'll definitely be interesting to see how these tributes' failing traits come into play in these games. And they're off! Katnip Neverclean taking a rather feminine approach to the mound.
Beezer strutting his way up.
Oh, it's Yamanashi hopping off of the stump, taking a little bit of an anime run. Oh, he fell. No problem, he's right back at it again.
Cato, the potato, what is he doing? Wrong way, he's coming back onto it. He looks furious.
What is Darnell doing? This is an approach I have never seen in all my years of sportcasting.
And here we come, up to the mound. Everyone's confused. Oh, what form? And here we go. Oh, wait, what's happening? Are they helping each other?
It seems they are, Aaron. It seems they're trying to actually equip each other to kill each other. I've never seen this strategy employed. We'll see how this plays out for them in the games.
You are right, Dan. I am confused. Here we have Cato helping out Beezer. I am confused.
What kind of strategy is this? Well, take a look at this. Look at this. You have Joseph Yamanashi stocking up in the back here, gaining all the firepower as the other tributes just try to help each other. This is a really big deal. This is going to give Yamanashi a lot. Oh, Yamanashi's already
going. He's gone.
Now we're down to the last four remaining. What are they doing? Still helping out each other. I don't know how this is going to pan out.
Take a look in the back there. It's Yamanashi making a break for the tree lines. That's a very strategic move. Very smart.
5 minutes later.
So some time has passed and all the tributes have left. The only one we have left is Cato Potato standing with all the... Oh, what just happened? It looked like he got shot. It's
Joseph Yamanashi!
Aaron, what more do we have on this man, Joseph Yamanashi?
Well, you see, Joseph is a really renowned video gamer known as Cyclops 98. He is very good at video games. His KD ratio on Call of Duty is 9 billion to 1.
Aaron, there's no questioning that his gaming habit is what made him fail his English course.
What do we have next? Wait, who is she, Dan?
I'll tell you, Aaron. This is Katnip Neverclean. She is an amazing contender. Her one fatal flaw is the fact that she is too fascinated with her own personal appearance, which could prove to be very risky in these games.
Yeah, Dan. Maybe this is the reason why she failed her English class.
Oh, it seems like she's looting the corpse of Cato Potato, grabbing everything that he owned, not even questioning what took him down.
And here is the body of... Cato's still alive!
How could this be? He's back from the dead. Cato, Potato for short, is back and ready to take out some tributes. Aaron, what's the scoop on this living legend?
Cato, also known as Potato, is an athletic legend. He is a master on the field and off. Anything that he does is pure excellence. Yet, this might be the cause of his poor performance in English class.
Looks like Cato is off into the arena to fight more tributes. Up next, we have the mascot of the English games, Jeffrey the Mockingjay. There he is sitting there, so majestic, so beautiful, such symbolism.
And here we have Katnip strolling through the grass, looking quite tired. Whoa, wait, she sees someone.
It's Beezer.
Hey Dan, can you give me the 411 on Beezer? And why is he doing driving a lawnmower?
Well, I'll tell you, Aaron. Beezer 12 Washingbeard is an absolute workaholic. He skips school just to do odd jobs so that he can make money for college. You wouldn't believe how much this overworked schedule negatively affects his academic performance.
You're my only hope, Hubble.
Eh!
Well, that is the end of Beezer. Now, let's take a look at the scenic area.
It's a beautiful arena, a deciduous forest. It's absolutely great. Camera One is providing us footage. What?
Cut to Camera Two. Cut to Camera Two. Whoa, that's much better. Wait, is this Darnell? What do we have on him?
Well, it's Darnell, hashtag Kimye Charcago Benjamin III. This man is completely insane. The reason he failed his English course was because of too much stress, and it looks like that stress has finally eaten away at his very being, turning him into a vicious animal.
And here we have Cato. He seems to be surveying the land. Oh, he seems to have found something.
I think it's... Who could he have found? It's Darnell. He found Darnell. It looks like they're gonna fight. Let's listen in.
And they are still going at it, going strong. What was that?
It looks like Darnell got shot. Oh, and Kato's out of here. Who could it be?
It's
Joseph Yamanashi!
Where does this man keep coming from? And he's got a kayak. Where do you get that from?
Lord knows. But let's see what's happening with Catnip.
Catnip? More like cat. What are you eating there?
I'm starving.
It's berries. They're really good for you.
Hey, Aaron, it seems that grass was poison.
Gotta get a selfie with my new victim.
What you say? That you only meant well, but of course you did. What you say? That it's all for the best, of course it is. What you say? That it's just what we need. You decided this. What you say?
That means the winner is Joseph Yamanashi.
Yamanashi, what do you have to say for yourself?
Hey,